When Thank you. opens her window.
Dress.
You'll need to put on another one before you meet the children.
But I don't have another. When we entered the abbey, our worldly clothes are given to the poor.
Well, what about this one?
Well, the poor didn't want this one. I would make myself a new dress, but there wasn't time. I can make clothes.
Good. Then I'll see that you get some material. Today, if possible. Now, Floraline.
Maria.
Maria. I'm not sure how much the Reverend Mother told you.
Not much.
You are the 12th governess in a long line of governesses that have come to look after my children. And I hope you're an improvement on the last one. She stayed only 2 hours.
What's wrong with the children, sir?
Oh, there's nothing wrong with the children. Only the governesses. They cannot maintain discipline, without which this house cannot be run. You'll do good to remember that, Fraulein.
Yes, sir.
Every morning you will drill the children in their studies. I will not have them dream away their summer holidays. And each afternoon, they will march the grounds, breathing deeply. And bedtime is to be strictly observed, no exceptions.
Excuse me, sir. When do they play?
You will see at all times that they maintain the utmost orderly decorum at all times. I am placing you in command.
Yes, sir.
Children, this is your new governess, Fraulein Maria. Now, when I sound your signal, you will step forward and state your name. Fraulein, you will listen. Listen to their signal so you can call them when you want them.
Liesel.
Friedrich.
Luisa.
Kurt.
Brigitte. Marta.
And that's Gretel. Now, Fraulein, let's see how well you listened.
Well, I won't need to whistle for them, Reverend Captain. I'll just use their names. They're such lovely names.
Fraulein, this house is very large, and the grounds are very extensive. I will not have you shouted. You will take this, please. Learn to use it. The children will help you if you have any problems. Now, if I want you, this is what you will hear.
Oh, no, sir. I'm sorry, sir. Never answer to a whistle. Whistles are for dogs and cats and other animals, but not for children, and definitely not for me. It'd be too humiliating.
Fraulein, were you this much trouble at the abbey?
Oh, much more, sir. Sorry, Captain, I don't know your signal.
You may call me Captain.
Will you please tell me all your names again and how old you are?
I'm Liesel, I'm 16, and I don't need a governess.
Well, I'm glad you told me that, Liesel. We'll just be good friends.
I'm Friedrich, I'm 15, and I'm impossible.
Really? Who told you that, Friedrich?
Fraulein Josephine, 4 governesses ago.
I'm Bernita.
You didn't tell me how old you are, Luisa.
I'm Brigida. She's Luisa. She's 14, and you're smart. I'm 12, and I think that is the most ugliest dress I ever saw.
Brigitte, you shouldn't say that.
Why not? Don't you think it's ugly?
Yes. But Fraulein Wilhelmina's was ugliest. I'm Kurt. I'm 13, and I'm incorrigible.
Really? Congratulations.
What does incorrigible mean?
I think it means you want to be treated like a man.
I'm Marta. I'm going to be 10 on Tuesday. I like a pink parasol.
Well, pink's my favorite color, too. Yes, and you're practical. And you're 8 years old? My, you're practically a lady. Now, I must tell you a secret. I've never been a governess.
You mean you've never been a governess before?
Never. I need lots of advice.
The best way to start is by telling Father to mind his own business.
You must never come to dinner on time.
Never eat your soup quietly.
And during dessert, always blow nose.
Why not?
Because I like you!
Oh.
Children, children, outside. It's time for your walk.
Father's orders.
Hello, Fraulein Maria.
I am Frau Schmidt. I am one of the housekeepers.
And I am Frau Helga. I am also a housekeeper. I pick up what she cannot pick up. which is very little indeed.
Fraulein Maria, I'm Frau Greta, and I take care of the kitchen.
Well, how do you do? Welcome to the Von Trapp family home.
Such a lovely place. So much different from the Abbey.
Yes, it's a beautiful place to live and a wonderful place to work.
I'll be trying to fix some of your favorite meals, as long as the captain is agreeable.
We might just have to wait until he's gone off on one of his very long visits
to the Barrens.
Yes, food seems to be getting harder to buy, with the worry of war on the borders and all that.
Oh, what a dreadful thought. We should believe that Austria will be strong for us and that we'll enjoy peace.
Enough, enough, enough talk about war. We have work to do.
We'll show you to your room.
Follow us.
You're lucky.
You only got a frog.
With Fraulein Wilma, it was a snake.
Good evening, children.
Good evening, Fraulein Maria.
Can I show you a little ritual? Something you learned at the Abbey.
No, rheumatism. Excuse me, Captain. Haven't we forgotten to thank the Lord for what we are about to receive? May the Lord make us truly thankful. Amen.
Amen.
I'd like to thank each and every one of you for the precious gift you left in my pocket today.
What gift?
It's a secret between the children and me.
Well, then I suggest you keep it and let us eat.
Knowing how nervous I must have been, stranger in a new household, knowing how important it was for me to feel accepted, it was so kind and thoughtful of you to make my first moments here so warm and pleasant and happy.
Marta, what's the matter?
Nothing.
Fraulein, is it to be at every meal, or just merely at dinner time, when you intend to lead us through this rare and wonderful new world of indigestion?
Oh, they're all right, Captain. They're just happy.
Good evening, Hans.
Good evening, Franz.
Tell me, Hans, since you bring messages to and from all military leaders, will Austria try to stop the invasion of the Germans?
The Austrians fight against the Germans? Not likely.
Then everything is under control.
Yes, everything is perfectly under control. The Austrian government won't even have time to blink before the mighty German tanks roll right into their capital.
Good. Ah, Rolf, there you are. Has there been any developments?
Perhaps. But Hans here is right. The Austrian government does not stand a chance against the powerful German army.
It will fall quickly. Like taking candy from a baby.
Dear Franz, before you know it, Hitler will have his troops marching through the streets of Salzburg. We are on our way to becoming a better nation.
Ah, yes. Seems only a matter of time until we unite with the German forces for the good of Austria.
Is the captain at home tonight?
Yes, he's at dinner.
With the family?
Yes.
Please give him this telegram at once.
Certainly. Excuse me, I have an important message for Captain Von Trapp.
Of course, but can you wait until they're finished eating dinner?
Excuse me, I have an errand to finish.
Right, Franz. Nothing should interrupt the family from eating their chocolate eclair dessert.
Franz, you must be careful. You know how the captain likes to follow strict rules of etiquette at dinner time.
Oh, please. Having one captain, please, is much easier than trying to satisfy the wishes of three women. Excuse me, sir. A message.
Franz, who delivered it?
Why, Hans Mueller and young lad Rolf, of course.
Father, may I be excused?
Children, I'll be going to Vienna in the morning.
Oh, no, don't again.
How long will you be gone this time, Father?
I'm not sure, Bethel, I'm not sure.
To visit Baroness Schrader again?
Mind your own business.
As a matter of fact, yes, I am.
When are we going to be able to see the Baroness?
Why would she want to see you? You're all going to see the Baroness because I'm bringing her back with me from my trip, along with Uncle Max.
Feelings towards the Germans. He won't like us spending even an extra minute at this home.
Just be patient.
Rolf! Oh, Rolf!
10 minutes, Rolf. Good evening, Franz.
No, Lisa, we mustn't.
Why not, silly?
I don't know.
Isn't this why you were waiting?
Well, yes, I've missed you, Liesl.
You have how much?
So much that I thought of writing a telegram just so that I could deliver it here.
Oh, what a lovely thought. Why don't you, right now?
But I'm here.
Please, Rolf, send me a telegram. I'll even start it for you. Dear Liesl.
Dear Liesl, I'd like to tell you how much I feel about you. Stop. But unfortunately, this telegram is already too expensive. Sincerely, Rolf.
Sincerely?
Cordially.
Cordially?
Affectionate. Will there be any reply?
Dear Rolf, stop. Don't stop. You're beautiful. Isn't it terrible that we have to wait for Father to receive a telegram? How do I ever know when I'll see you again?
Well, I could come here by mistake with a telegram from Colonel Schneider. He's here from Berlin, but don't tell your father about this.
Why not?
Well, he's so Austrian.
We're all Austrian.
Yeah, well, some people think we ought to be Germans, and they're very angry at those who don't agree.
Oh, don't worry about Father. He's a big naval hero who was even decorated by the Austrian Emperor. No one would dare hurt him.
I'm not worried about him. I'm worried about his daughter.
Me? Why?
Well, you're such a...
Such a what?
Such a baby.
I'm 16. What's such a baby about that?
You are so- Getting to know you. Round paper. Where do they come from? I don't remember seeing anyone with a gun
Yes, they're here under Hitler's orders to help us maintain peace.
Look! There's somebody over there!
Children, stand behind me.
Halt! Stop right there! Do not notice step aside when we pass. Give us the respect we deserve. We are protecting you.
From whom? Fraulein Maria?
What?
Boy, you'll soon learn to keep your tongue inside your mouth if you don't want it removed.
Yes, within a few weeks we will be the law. You will give us the sidewalk when we approach. You will walk in the gutters.
But why? This is our town.
Your town? Ha! Soon you'll be seeing many changes in your town, so you might as well get used to obeying the laws of the German Führer, Adolf Hitler. He'll soon be taking control of all the towns in Austria, just as he has done in Poland and Holland.
So like you said, the sooner you see the idea, the happier you will be.
But I thought I was already happy.
Children, I suggest we stand over here. Thank you for your warnings, Herr
Zilla. I'm sure you can get it, Fraulein. Now, face. Park.
Well, that just ruins all the fun we've been having.
Yeah, we were having such a good time. Let's think of something else. I think the time we put
clue
on following Jolt's feet too.
It's easy.
Yes, but why do it?
How else are we supposed to get Father's attention?
Oh, I see. Let's think about that one, won't we? All right, everybody, over here.
But what are we going to do?
Think of something to sing for the Baroness.
But Father doesn't like us to sing.
Well, perhaps we can change his mind. What songs do you know?
We don't know any song.
Not any.
We don't even know how to sing.
Nope. Let's not lose time. You must learn.
Let's start at the very beginning. A very good place to start.
When you read, you begin with
A, B, C.
When you sing, you begin with
Do, Re, Mi.
Do, Re, Mi.
So
do la fa.
Thank you. America in the last few days. There might be other groups that sing about the love of their country. Somewhere, another hungry sing group is waiting for Maxwell Detweiler to pluck it out of obscurity and make it famous at the Salzburg Folk Festival.
They get the fame, you get the money.
It's unfair, I admit, but someday that will be changed. I should get the fame, too.
Tell me about the Salzburg Folk Festival.
It's the largest festival in Europe. Contestants come from surrounding nations to compete in the Song and Dance Festival, held right here in the little lovely town of Salzburg. Have you ever attended, Georg?
Me? Why, of course not. I've never had the slightest urge to watch such a show.
Like I said, you're missing one of those entertaining festivals around. Speaking of entertaining, that was quite a genre, wasn't it?
Good heavens, what was it?
No, dear, I don't know. Max, that was nothing. Just some local urchins. That's all.
Well, here at your home now, so I think I'll go on ahead.
This is really very nice, Georg, being with you here.
Oh, me. Trees, houses. When you've seen one, you've seen them all.
That's not what I mean, and you know it.
Oh, you mean me. I'm interested.
Is that so hard to believe?
No, but it's very improbable.
There you go, running yourself down again.
Well, I'm a dangerous driver.
Oh, I do like it here, Georg. It is so lovely and peaceful. How do you leave it so often as you do?
Oh, pretending to be mad and active, I suppose. Activity suggests a life of purpose, does it not?
Or could it be that you're running away from memories?
Yeah. Oh, I'm just trying to find a reason to stay.
I do hope that's why you've been visiting Vienna so often. Or were there other distractions there?
Oh, I hardly call it a distraction, I think.
Well, what would you call me, Georg?
Lovely, charming, witty, the perfect hostess, and you're going to hate me for this, but my greatest comfort.
Oh, how unromantic.
I'd be an ungrateful wretch if I didn't tell you that it was you who brought some meaning back into my life.
I am amusing. I have the biggest couture in Vienna and a splittering circle of friends. I do throw some rather lively parties.
Oh, yes, you do.
But take all that away and you just have a wealthy, lonely me, searching for someone to share my life with, just like you.
Good luck.
Sky, check in on you two. Should have been.
More sugar, is that why?
How many have I had?
Two.
Make it an uneven.
You are still eating, I see. You must be unhappy.
I was just working on a deal with a marvelous new quartet from Vienna. I was trying to steal them away from Scholl and Holbrook.
Well, what happened, Max?
Yesterday, Sasha Petrie stole them first. There's one thing I hate, it's a thief.
Well, Max, you must learn to love yourself, my friend.
To sort out the confusion, I had to call Paris, Rome, and Stockholm.
Using Georg's telephone.
Of course, also by Portage. Oh, I love rich people. I love the way they live. I love the way I live, and I miss them.
I wonder where the children are. I haven't seen them in a while.
They must have heard I was coming and hid.
I was hoping they'd be here so they could greet you.
Well?
Well, what?
Do I hear wedding bells?
Feeling badly.
Marvelous.
But not necessarily for me.
What kind of talk is that?
None of your business. I'm very fond of Georg, and I don't want you to toy with us.
But I'm a child. I like toys. Well, tell me everything. Tell me every itsy-bitsy, intimate, disgusting detail.
Well, let's just say I think I'm here on
the beach. I approve that. How can you miss?
Far too easy.
If I know you, my dear, and I do, you will find a way.
Well, he's no ordinary man.
Of course not. He's rich.
When his wife died, she left him with a terrible heartbreak.
And when your husband died, he left you with a terrible fortune.
Oh, Max.
You and Gary are like family to me. That's why I want to see you two get married. Must keep all that lovely money in the family. But Elsa, have you made up Burr's mind yet? Is he going to marry him?
Yes, he just hasn't admitted it yet. There seems to be something standing in the way.
And you don't know what it is?
No.
I do. It's simple. It's money.
Money?
Yes. He's rich, and you're rich.
Oh, Max. Hello, where are you? You seem so
world that's disappearing, I'm afraid.
Well, is there anything I can do to bring you back to the world I'm in?
So, I need a calling pen. La, a note to follow, so.
Don't go. I'm sorry. I behaved badly. Will you forgive me?
I'm far too outspoken. It's one of my worst faults.
You brought music back into the house. I had forgotten. And I want you to stay. I asked you to stay.
If I could be of any help.
You already have been. More than you know.
Please tell us
Uncle Max?
A singing group, all in one family. You'll never guess, Theo.
Whose family?
Yours. They'll be talking festival.
No, Max.
But you heard them yourself. They'll be a sensation.
No, Max.
It's a wonderful idea.
No.
Fresh, original.
Max! My children will not and do not sing in public.
I tried, but ears can't blame you for trying.
Children, who should we hear from next? The vote is yes. You, Patrick.
Me?
Please.
Why, I haven't played in years.
I told you were quite good.
Well, that was a very long time ago.
I remember, Father. Yes, quite something we know.
How long is it?
Around the
feature me. So every star and every whirling planet and every constellation in the sky revolves around the center of the universe, a lovely thing called I. And there's no way to stop it, no, there's no way to stop it, and you can't stop it even if you try. No, I'm not going to worry, so I'm not going to worry. Every time I see another thing go by, nothing else as wonderful.
Unfortunately, Dieter, you are correct.
But with a good meal and a good drink, even the Austrian dances can be quite enjoyable.
Baroness, you shall have to save a dance for me. I shall teach you a German step, which would be can get quite nicely with this style of music.
Likewise.
If you'll excuse me, boys, I'm feeling a bit ill.
Johann, Dieter! Did you notice how the captain made an artist's display of the Austrian flag in the hallway?
Yes, Herr Zeller.
I thought that displaying the Austrian flag would be outlawed by Hitler.
I guess we'll just have to teach the captain the German punishments
for those who do not know how to mind an angry man.
Yes, but first we must eat and
drink. No! We must fight Franz. We should have warned the captain there's a penalty against this outlander's display of loyalty to Austria.
I see him over there. Franz, Franz.
Yes, sir. Is there something wrong?
Don't you know it's illegal to hang an Austrian flag in the hallway?
I did not hang it. It was the captain's wish. He did it.
We must find a way to make the captain change his mind.
Thank you. they look ugly.
I think you're just scared of them.
No, silly. Only grown men are afraid of women.
I think the men look beautiful. How would you know?
Liesl, who are you dancing with?
Nobody.
Oh, yes, you are.
May I have this dance?
I'd be delighted.
Why didn't you children tell me you could dance?
We were afraid you'd make us all dance together. I can see it right now, the Bone Trap Family dancing.
What are they playing?
It's the Landlords, an Austrian folk dance.
Show me.
Oh, right, I haven't danced that since I was a little girl.
You remember, please.
Well,
please.
Okay, let's go. Now, you go, and I first.
Like this?
There you go. Now, one, step together, step, hop, and under. Oh, great, that's it. Okay, try it.
May I?
And observe.
Young lady, I must have a word with you. Georg, you won't let her get away. She must join the party.
No, really,
I... You can if you like.
I insist. You shall be my dinner partner. Franz?
Yes, sir.
Set in the place next to mine, Fräulein Ria.
Whatever you say, sir.
It seems to be all arranged.
It certainly does.
I'm not suitably dressed.
Well, you can change. We'll wait for you.
You must be very proud of your youngsters, Captain.
Oh, yes, I am. Thank you.
Is there a more beautiful expression of what is good in our country than the innocent voices of our children?
Oh, come now, Fräulein. Do you really expect that Archer holds monopoly of virtue?
There's other. Some of us would rather hear children's voices raised in song than ugly German threats.
Oh, nonsense, Captain. The Germans do not threaten. They bring a new order of prosperity and peace.
Peace? That is preposterous.
It would be peaceful if the Ottomans were not all blind to the logic of the Third Reich.
Captain, if only you look past your obsession for Austria and see the greater good that we, I mean the Nazis, have to offer.
Now, Artel, you're not going to stoop so low as to say evil is good, now are you?
Captain, Herr Richter is right.
Remember, Captain von Trapp, the Austrians may bury his head in the sand and sometimes in the flood. People may warn you that the Nazis are coming, and they are coming. And you might get further if you convert your words into music.
Herzella, if the Nazis invade, I'm sure that you will be the entire trumpet section.
You flatter me.
Oh, how clumsy of me. I meant to insult you.
It's very kind of you to offer to help me, Baroness.
I'm delighted, Maria.
I'm not sure I'd have anything that would be appropriate.
Now, where's that lovely little thing you were wearing the other evening, when the captain couldn't keep his eyes off you?
Couldn't keep his eyes off me?
Come, my dear. We are women. Let's not pretend we don't realize when a man notices us.
But the captain notices everybody.
There's no need to feel so defensive, Maria. You are a lovely woman. The captain hardly would be a man if he didn't notice you.
Baroness, I hope you're joking.
Not at all.
But I haven't done a thing to.
You don't need to, my dear. The only thing more attractive, there's nothing more attractive to a man than a woman who's in love with him.
In love with him?
Of course, my dear. What makes it so much funnier is he thinks he's in love with you. But don't worry about that. He'll get over that. Men do, you know.
Then I should go. I must just stay here.
Is there anything I can do?
No, there's nothing you can do. Wait, there is something you can do to help me. Don't say a word, Mrs. Captain.
Oh, I would dream of it. Goodbye, Maria. I'm sure you'll make a very fine note.
Let's pretend we're on the stage at the festival.
I don't feel like singing.
Not without Fräulein Maria.
Liesl, get the guitar. Come on, Marta. Everybody in the group, in your places. Be cheerful. Away from Liesl. Okay, give us the key, Liesl. Now, impress me. Come on, everybody. Play something you know. Enjoy it. Be cheerful. Liesl?
Am I interrupting something here, Max?
Oh, they just want to sing for me. Bless their hearts.
Well, that's lovely. Don't stop.
Actually, something stronger laced with lemonade.
Father, I don't believe it.
Don't believe what?
About Fräulein Maria.
Oh, Fräulein Maria. Did I not tell you what her note said? She said she missed her life at the Abbey too much, and she had to go back. And that's all there is to it.
She didn't even say goodbye.
She did in her note.
Just too pink.
Who's our new governess, Pumpkin?
Well, you're not going to have a governess anymore.
We're not?
No. You're going to have a new mother. We talked it over last night, and we're all going to be very happy.
Sorry. Why did they send you back?
They didn't send me back. I left.
Tell me what happened.
I was frightened.
Frightened?
Were they unkind to you?
Oh, no, no.
I felt confused. I've never felt that way before. I knew that here I'd be away from it. I'd be safe.
Maria, our Abbey is not to be used as an escape.
What was it you couldn't face? I couldn't face him again.
Him? Captain Von Trapp? Are you in love with him?
I don't know. I don't know. The Baroness said I was. She said that he was in love with me, but I didn't want to believe it.
Did you let him see your feelings?
If I did, I didn't know it. I was on God's errand. To ask for the captain's love would have been wrong. I just couldn't stay. I just couldn't. I'm ready at this moment to take my vows. Please let me.
Maria, the love of a man and a woman can be holy too.
Maria, you have a great capacity to love. Now all you need to do is find out how God wants you to spend your love.
But I pledge my life to God. I pledge my life to his service.
But Maria, if you love this man, it doesn't mean you love God any less.
Yes, you must go and face your problems.
Oh, you can't ask me to do that, please.
Maria, perhaps if you go, these walls are not built to shut out problems. You must go out and face them. You must live the life you were born.
Talk to her.
One of grass tastes sad.
I feel awful.
When Paula and Maria wanted to feel better, she used to sing that song.
Yeah, let's try.
Oh, no, sit down, please. May I?
Of course.
I've been wondering two things. One, why did you leave? And what made you come back?
Well, I had an obligation to fulfill, and I came back to fulfill it.
Is that all?
Well, and I miss the children.
Yeah, only the children.
Yes, no. Isn't it right that I miss them?
Well, yes, of course. I was only hoping that you might.
Yes.
Well, nothing was the same when you were away. And it'll all go back to that when you're gone. I was only hoping you would change your mind.
Well, I'm sure the Baroness will make things just right for you.
Maria, there isn't going to be any Baroness.
There isn't?
No.
I can understand.
You called off our engagement, you see.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, you are?
You did?
Yes, well, you can't marry someone when you're in love with someone else, can you?
The Reverend Mother always says when the Lord closes a door, somewhere he opens a window.
And what else does the Reverend Mother say, Maria?
That you have to find life.
And have you found it?
I think so. Can this really be happening? Can you really love me?
Hallelujah. Bumpy road, don't you think? You need to get it redone or something. Apparently all the lines have been cut.
We missed all the noise we make in the morning telling each other to be quiet.
Well, mostly we just hear you sing.
We have so many things to tell you.
Yes. Look, Fran, Maria. I mean, Mother.
We're going to be in a festival.
We've
tonight.
Been practicing.
Oh, really?
The committee was enchanted, though.
Do I care?
Max, what did they say?
I've never heard such enthusiasm.
Oh, darling, this would be just this one.
Absolutely out of the question.
Georg, this is for Austria.
Austria? There is no Austria.
But the overthrow of the Austrian government was peaceful. Let's at least be grateful for that.
Grateful! You know, Max, sometimes I don't believe I know you.
Oh, Father, I forgot. This is for you.
Maria, you must at least pretend to work with these people. You must convince him.
Oh, Max, I can't ask him for something less than he is. You know how devoted he is to this country. This is home.
Then I'll talk to him. If those children don't sing the festival, well, it'll be a reflection on Austria. Oh, I know, it wouldn't do me any good either.
Mother? Oh, I just love calling you Mother.
I like hearing it.
You love Father very much. I can tell you do.
Very much.
Mother, what do you do when you think you're in love? Or rather, you stop loving someone or they stop loving you?
Well, you cry a little. Sometimes you cry a lot. Then you wait for the sun to come out. It always does.
I just think I should know so much, but I don't.
Well, how can you? You're still very, very young.
Sometimes I feel like the world is coming to an end.
And then you feel it's just beginning.
Yes.
That's the way it was for me. Just as wonderful for you.
You really think so?
Absolutely unthinkable, out of the question. Maria, Sonia, we're going to have to leave this house. We have to leave Austria. Tonight. Gather the kids. Don't do anything to worry about.
Jam and bread.
With jam,
ABC.
now we have a number by the Kotlin Kletler Verdongen. I think it'll work. I shall miss you all. I shall miss all the money I would have gained on you, too.
And first prize, and I have honor and honor.
all of Austria. The Von Trapp Family Singer! The Baron Von Trapp! The Von Trapp Family!
They're gone!
They couldn't have gone far!
Quick, check all the exits! They must be found! Where'd they go?
Quick, come with me to the Abbey.
Reverend Mother.
Yes?
We need your assistance.
We didn't realize we were going to be in this much danger, but we need your help.
No, Maria, you're not free to come here.
I have a place to hide.
Good. But I was wondering if we could borrow your caretaker's car.
I'm afraid the car will do you no good now.
Well, why?
Borders are closed.
Look, the borders are closed. We'll take your car and drive to the hills. But then we'll walk over on foot into Switzerland.
What about the children?
We'll help them.
We can do it without them, Father.
Remember, safety in the hills.
Yes, Maria. Go over the Alps into Switzerland. You know the hills well. There you will be safe.
I'm scared.
I want to go home.
Me too.
God be with you, children.
Mother, would it help if we sang about our favorite things?
No, no. This is a time of not time. This time we must be very quiet. Well, thank me.
Come with me, children. I have a place to hide in the graveyard.
Thank you, Reverend Mother. You have saved our lives.
Oh, no, man.
isn't praying. Let me loose. Hey.
Safely out of Austria.
Look, Father, it's Switzerland!
Yeah.